here's something that I didn't know how I wanted to deal with this. I had left it out before, but I want to have my ode to snitching in 2006. Of course, we've had a situation with the Busta Rhymes Touchy remix video. We've had, you know, Lil' Kim case back on television with, you know, the countdown and lockdown, whatever that was. I watched it once. I watched the last episode before now. I just couldn't get into it. It's just too sad. The nose, everything. I can't watch. But I finally want to give my opinion on the whole Stop Snitching movie. And I can wrap it all up, my entire feelings about it, in this one picture. Look at the t-shirt. Look at the guy wearing the t-shirt. That, my friends, is Benji Madsen from Good Charlotte. As you see, he has on a Stop Snitching t-shirt. It is official. The Stop Snitching movement is a wrap. You see it? America's laughing at you. Benji Madsen has on a Stop Snitching t-shirt. The movement's over. Don't wear the t-shirts. Don't say it. Don't promote it. It's idiotic. It was idiotic to begin with, but now, you see, right? Benji Madsen. Oh, it's not valid. It lost all credibility. It's over. Don't bring it up. It's gone. If you see something going on, you want to snitch on somebody, go right ahead. And they're doing something wrong. Now, on the flip side, I've got some stories I want to bring to your attention where snitching is involved, and now, not all of these I can really get with it. Some of these are really, really great examples of when you shouldn't be snitching. And let's start with Carrie Kelly, who's R. Kelly's brother. Shout out to my man Ray Daniels, because Ray's the one that interviewed him for the Drama Magazine DVD. So I ain't hating on Ray. And, you know, he puts a pre on the back cover, but he freaking didn't tell me. And now she was all mad at me. Why don't you just tell me, man, so I can get her a copy, so she can stop hollering on me. Ray, if you watch this, give me a damn copy of the DVD. But, of course, we all know he had some very reckless things to say about his brother. He said his brother wanted to pay him $50,000 to say it was him that was on that underage girl tape. He said his brother was even showing it around all his friends about the tape. And he even called his brother bisexual. Okay, now, all these things were said. Allegedly, you know, these are allegations made by Carrie on his brother Robert. He said he's doing this because somehow Robert Kelly is blackballing his music career. Not a good enough reason, because I don't believe you would have ever had a music career. As all this time, R. Kelly been on top of R&B 15 years. I turned 26 this week. He been on top since like 92. He had the public announcement and Sparkle and Changing Faces. He ain't talking Changing Faces. He did a bit something. He had a lot of people he put on and he never put you on. And it seems real hateful that now you throwing him under the bus. Maybe your brother threw you under the bus, you getting back at him. But I think this is the case of snitching going awry. I don't think he should have said nothing, but I do think it's entertaining and do chuckle when I watch the DVD. Another example of in-family snitching. Tina Brown, Bobby Brown's sister, took pictures of Whitney Houston's drug-induced house area, took pictures of vials in the bathroom, and sold them to the National Enquirer, talking about she was trying to save her sister-in-law. You are a snitch. Because we already know she's high on that stuff. Cocaine brings you pain, and of course, crack is whack. But your sister-in-law doesn't care. I didn't appreciate Tina having the audacity to say that even in her most horrific state, Whitney Houston still is encountered with girl-on-girl relations. As you all know, I am a fan of the L word, and I'm really disturbed by the fact that Whitney Houston is convinced anybody else to sleep with her. I think it's rude and lewd and disgusting. And I wish Tina Brown had kept that to herself, because I am a supporter of the L word, and we cannot support such actions from Whitney Houston. So you keep your mouth shut. I think Whitney Houston's getting some help. Hope she gets all the help she needs. But you, Tina, stop selling pictures of that man's and woman's house and putting in get some money. You stop it. That ain't right. And since I'm speaking on Whitney, have you seen the pictures of their daughter, Bobby Christina? Oh, is she not a harlot in training? Every time I see her pictures, she is starting to look more and more like she wants to do my DC ass pose. Hey, pause! I told you about my DC ass pose. Roll it. All my monies, they don't pay me nothing. I own DC ass pose. I said it last time, y'all were stealing my gangster, give me money! And Bobby Christina, don't you never do my pose. You a child. Somebody rein that child. Tina, stop focusing on Whitney and rein in your niece. That's what you should be doing. I got something special for you. I've got something really, really special for you. This is something I just love to do here on the show. We haven't done it in a while, but prepare your minds, your hearts, and your souls to enjoy another episode of Grand Panda Poo Kung Fu Theater. What the?